Hi everyone, and welcome back to Tech Interceptor. Well, today we are taking a look one of a new Intel B760 motherboard. This is the motherboard in question. This is the ASRock B760M Steel Legend WIFI. First of all, remember to subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell to stay up to date on upcoming videos, and if you want to take a look at our Twitter and Instagram profiles. Anyway, let's get on now. The motherboard of which we talk you belongs of the newest ASRock Intel B760 lineup. Into the box, together of course, the Mambo, we find the user manual, 2 set of 3 6 GB/s cable, 2 Wi-Fi antennas, 3 screw for M2 socket, and a 3 standoff for M2 socket. Dimensionally, the new ASRock B760 board has a micro ATX form factor, and its size 9.6 for 9.6 inches or 24.4 for 24.4 cm. All components of a board, such as connectors, capacitor, heatsink, links on square black PCB. The cooling solution seems very good. We haven't skimped with heatsinks, are present various elements. Above the capacitor and the MOSFET, there are 2 silver metal brushed heatsinks with thermal pad on top and on left. These almost merge in the corner to form a half of a frame. The second, the one on left, the CPU socket, prunes itself with a cover along the I/O panel. After, we have the heatsink for B760 chipset and the 2 hour that aims the heat dissipation of M2 sockets. The whole surface of a motherboard has a silver and a black color scheme, and it is enriched with many things. On the lower part and near to the CPU socket by a particular geometrical pattern. In addition, like whatever our motherboard, is reported the name, as well as on the heatsink with the same geometrical pattern. So, just a second ago on the PCB, additional lines and text like as ASRock, Steel Legend and M2 Armor. And lastly, a little particular, the RGB Steel Legend logo. Moving to the technical aspect, the VRM layout is composed by 12 plus 1 plus 1 digital power faces that guarantee the maximum efficiency and the power necessary. The core of a new B760 board features the Intel 1700 socket. Plus, to the B760 motherboard, the last Intel socket is designed also for top-range Z790 motherboard and for the new entry-level H770 mobiles. The Intel 1700 CPU socket supports the 13th generation Intel Core processors, however, it's backward compatible with whatever previous 12th generation Intel Core processor, including the Intel Core, Pentium and Celeron CPU. The current generation including a massive number of processors, where we can underline the presence of the i5-13600K, i7-13700K and the i9-13900K CPU. Specifically, in terms of specifications, there are dissimilars from each other. The Core i5-13600K has a 14 core, of which 6 performance core and 8 efficient core, 12 thread, 5.1 GHz of boost clock, 24 MB of cache, all with a TDP of 125 watts. The Core i7-13700K has a 16 core, of which 8 performance core and 8 efficient core, 24 thread, 5.4 GHz of boost clock, 13 MB of cache and a TDP of 125 watts. While the flagship 4-core i9-13900K as the 24-core, 8 and 6 performance and efficient cores, respectively 32-thread, 5.8 GHz of boost clock, 46 MB of cache, all with a TDP of 125 watts. The same goes for the price, with the Core i5-13600K sells at $330, the Core i7-13700K is around $420, and the Core i9-13900K at $180 more than the i7. The motherboard is equipped with 4 DDR5 DIMM dual channel memory architecture, the latest generation of memory technology for PC. Compared to DDR4, the DDR5 architecture is designed to provide some improvement, such as higher performance, high speed, as well as the unamplified capacity and a better power efficiency. All this in spite of higher price. We can install a minimum of 32 GB for single DIMM memory module up to a maximum capacity of 128 GB for all 4 DIMM. Operating base frequency for memory can range from 4800 MHz to an incredible frequency of over 7200 MHz in overclocking. Moving to the motherboard layout internal connection, starting from the left on top we have got a 8 plus 8-pin ATX 12V power connector for our CPU, a CPU fan header and another CPU fan or water cooling pump fan header. After going down on the right, there are a post status checker with which see eventually CPU, memory, graphic card or boot errors, two addressable Gen 2 headers, a 24-pin ATX main power socket connector and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, a front panel Type-C USB 3.2 Gen 2 header, a chassis or water cooling pump fan header and a 4 SATA 3 6GB to second port. At the bottom, the ASRock B760 mobile has a system panel header, a chassis intrusion and speaker header, a SPI TPM header, two USB 2.0 header, two our chassis or water pump fan connector, an RGB LED header, an addressable LED header, a clear CMOS jumper and a front panel audio header. Instead, on back, the I/O panel has a display port, two antenna jack, a HDMI port, two USB 2.0 port, a PS2 mouse keyboard port, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, and a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type E port, and a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type C port, the 2.5G LAN RJ35 port, two hour USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type C ports, and in the end, the audio jacks including lightning input port with light blue coloring, front speaker input port with lime finish and a microphone input port with a pink color. For have more storage, the new B760 motherboard boasts 4 SATA 3 6GB to second connector and a 3 M.2 slot. All 3 support storage devices type 2260 and 2280 PCI Express Gen 4 operating at a 4-4 mode. This means that these be able to running at a 64GB to second. In terms of expansion slot, it has one reinforced PCI Express 5.0 for 16 slot operating at a 416 mode and one another smaller PCI Express 4.0 for one slot. The audio skill of a new mobile aren't many. In fact, the audio compartment is powered by the Realtek ELC897 audio codec, but allow to have a 7.1 channel high definition audio with the addition of a dynamic audio feature. But now it is the time to talk about the price. Well, to get you hand on the ASRock B760M Steel Legend Wi-Fi motherboard, you won't have to spend a lot. It is available at a price of around $170 at the time of making this video. As always, I leave you all links to buy it in the description below. Okay, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was helpful. As always, let me know what do you think in the comments below. Leave a like, share it with all your friends and don't forget to subscribe. Huge thanks for watching. See you again next time.